Good morning and welcome to Central United Methodist Church on this Sunday, my last Sunday as your Director of Family Ministries. Will you join me in our sanctuary?
Hello, friends. Welcome to our worship at Central United Methodist Church on the fourth Sunday after Easter. This morning's service has been carefully prepared by our Director of Family Ministries, Alan Cook. This is his last official Sunday with us, and he has called this service a worship menu. There are seven courses. And so I invite you to celebrate with us as we experience Alan's leadership.
In November 2018, Robbie Fredrickson and I were asked to lead a worship service the Sunday after Thanksgiving. We chose to pattern the service after a dinner menu. So with that in mind, I have prepared today's worship service as a menu that contains beautiful music, inspiring scripture, and the spoken word. I believe the idea of a dinner menu is appropriate because my time on the staff has been spent on bringing people to the table, a table filled with fellowship, food, and friendship. I believe that the doors of the church should be taken down and made into tables around which we can gather and listen to each other and there find the love of Jesus. With the help of Ned Leyba, I have chosen to read The Parting Glass by Seamus Heaney for our centering prayer. Of all the money that e'er I had, I spent it in good company, and all the harm I've ever done, alas, it was to none but me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass. Good night and joy be to you all. So fill to me the parting glass and drink a health where'er it befalls. Then gently rise and softly call. Good night and joy be to you all. Of all the comrades that e'er I had, they're sorry for my going away. And all the sweethearts that e'er I had, they wish me one more day and stay. But since it fell into my lot that I should rise and you should not, I gently raise and softly call. Good night, and joy be to you all. Fill me the parting glass and drink a health, whatever befalls. Then gentle rise and softly call. Good night, and joy be to you all. But since it fell into my lot that I should rise and you should not, I'll gently rise and softly call. Good night, and joy be to you all. So fill me the parting glass and drink a health, whate'er befalls. Then gently rise and softly call. Good night, and joy be to you all. Good night, and joy be to you all.
Thank you. join us in the call to worship. With great rejoice, we come to the house of the Lord today.
God is our refuge and our stronghold.
The power and love of God flows through us, flows through this gathering.
We place our whole trust in God's abiding compassions for us.
Come, let us worship the Lord.
Let us celebrate the presence of God here in this sacred space in all of our lives. Amen.
God of new beginnings, help us to be open to your insights and ideas. May we be challenged to look beyond ourselves, to try new things, to be open to new experiences. Help us to let go of our prejudices in our long-held perceptions and those opinions that shape what we take in, so that we may be open to your calling in our lives, to the needs of the world. Guide us to follow you, the one who leads us into life. Amen.
Our first scripture reading is found in the Children of God Storybook Bible by Archbishop Desmond Tutu. It is based on a story found in Mark 10. Jesus spent many hours teaching people about God and how he loves us all. One day, when Jesus was tired and resting, some parents arrived with their children. The children were giggling and laughing and running around making noise while their parents asked the disciples if they could speak with Jesus. "What do you want with the master?" asked the disciples. "We want him to bless our children." "The master is resting," the disciples said. "You can't bother him now. Go home." But Jesus heard them. "Do not chase away the children," he called. "Let them come to me. God loves children, and when they smile, he smiles. When they laugh, he laughs. When they cry, he cries." Jesus went to the children, and they laughed and played together for a while. He took them in his arms and hugged them. He placed his hands on their hands and blessed them. Then he told the disciples, "Everyone who wants to see God's dream come true must see with the eyes of a child." Thank you for everything, Alan.
Friends, this morning I thought it would be so appropriate for some of the children and youth of our congregation to lead us in this children's moment. And so I've invited several of them to share very briefly some of their thoughts about Alan Cook.
Happy retirement, Mr. Allen.
We're gonna miss you.
Hi, Alan. Thank you so much for all you've done for the church. You've played such an important role in my faith and my connection with God throughout my life. You've been at this church as long as I can remember, and I'm so grateful for all you've done for me and for our whole church and community as a whole.
Thank you, Alan.
Gee, look, Alan, you're the best for all the churches I've been to. I'm really sad we're going to not be coming for a very long time. Bye.
Today, our affirmation of faith is adapted from the writings of Justo Gonzalez, a Cuban-American Methodist historian and theologian, a prolific author, and an influential contributor to the development of Latin American theology. St. Oscar Romero has become a focus of unity across people of all beliefs and none, calling us to profess all that gathers us in common values rather than the things which may divide us. And so, we affirm by saying,
we believe in God, all-loving, creator of the heavens and earth, creator of all people who are made in God's likeness. We believe in Jesus Christ, God's Son, our Lord God, made flesh for all humanity. God made flesh in love and grace for all creation. We believe in the Holy Spirit, through whom the living Christ makes his presence known to all peoples and gives power to become a new creation, sharing in the gifts of God. We believe in the church, which must be a sign of God's love and in the coming of God's reign. We believe in the reign of God, when all creation will bear the fruits of God's love and all people will sing the harmony of heaven. And because we believe, we commit ourselves to love, to dream, to pray, to reach out, to build until the day when that hope becomes a reality. Amen.
Friends, as we continue our worship, let us join our hearts in prayer. Loving, creating, holy God, we ask your presence in our world. We are so in need of healing, healing for racial injustice, healing for illness, whether physical or psychic, healing for our environment. And loving God, on this day, we ask your special presence with those in our midst who are undergoing surgery, Becky Cameron on Tuesday. We ask your continued healing presence with Gary Putnam and with others who are receiving treatments. Be with us, God, that we in our community might share your love broadly in the world. And hear us now as we are bold to join our voices in the prayer Jesus taught long ago. Our God in heaven, your name is holy. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today the food we need and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, for yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Happy retirement, Alan. We're here on the steps in our beautiful sanctuary. I'm gonna miss you very much. We've got to hang out at least once a week for the last year plus, which I know not a lot of people have got their FaceTime with you, and I just appreciate it so much. And we'll see you soon. By the rivers of Babylon, where he sat down, and there he wept, when he remembered Zion. Oh, but the wicked carry us away, captivity required from us this song. How can we sing King Alpha's song in a rivers of Babylon, where he
sat down, and there he wept when he remembered Zion. Oh, but the wicked carry us away.
Our gospel reading this morning is from Matthew chapter 5, verses 1 through 12. It is found in the Common English Bible Stories, Storyteller's Bible. Now when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up a mountain. He sat down and his disciples came to him. He taught them, saying,
Mapalad ang mga taong walang inaasahan kundi ang Diyos, sapagkat mapapabilang sila sa kaharian ng langit. Mapalad ang mga nagdadalamhati, sapagkat aaliwin sila ng Diyos.
Happy are people who are humble, because they will inherit the earth. Happy are people who are hungry and thirsty for righteousness, because they will be fed until they are full.
Phước cho những kẻ hay thương xót, vì sẽ được thương xót. Phước cho những kẻ có lòng trong sạch, vì sẽ thấy Đức Chúa Trời. Phước cho những người tạo hòa bình, vì sẽ được gọi là con Đức Chúa Trời.
Happy are people whose lives are harassed because they are righteous, because the kingdom of heavens is theirs. Happy are you when people insult you and harass you and speak all kinds of bad and false things about you, all because of me.
Be full of joy and be glad. You have a great reward in heaven.
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable, O Lord, my strength and my Redeemer. Amen. These words from Psalm 19, verse 14, began most of my father's sermons. Many times when I had the privilege of preaching in this sanctuary, I have begun my sermons with these familiar words. Today is my way to honor my father's spirit. It is appropriate that I stand in the aisle of this beautiful sanctuary. It's been a privilege to share stories with children and with you, the rest of the congregation, in this sacred space. You have heard my retelling of scripture, the use of my own thoughts, by sharing stories and through books. Perhaps you will remember past Christmas Eve family services, storytellers sharing stories in this space. our children's choir singing praises to God on the steps behind me, and the unrolling of the word we do not speak during Lent, and then to hear the enthusiasm of the children as they raise their voices in saying Alleluia on Easter morn. Thank you to our readers who read Matthew 5, verses 1 through 12 in their birth languages this morning. Listen closely to the words found in the Common English Storyteller Bible. Now when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up a mountain. He sat down and his disciples came to him. He taught them, saying, "Happy are people who are hopeless, because the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Happy are people who grieve, because they will be made glad. Happy are people who are humble, because they will inherit the earth. Happy are people who are hungry and thirsty for righteousness' sake, because they will be fed until they are full. Happy are people who show mercy, because they will receive mercy. Happy are people who have pure hearts, because they will see God. Happy are people whose lives are harassed because they are righteous, because the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Happy are you when people insult you and harass you and speak all kinds of bad and false things about you, all because of me. Be full of joy and be glad, because you have a great reward in heaven." The beauty of the Beatitudes is found in the beauty of the languages that were spoken. In Tagalog, in Vietnamese, Cambodian, and in a language from Sierra Leone, and English. The words are not only found on the pages of Matthew, but they are painted on walls, on wall hangings embroidered in Cambodia, and excerpts are even tattooed on arms. What if I were to tell you that the Beatitudes are about transformation, not just the world, but of ourselves? A transformation that life-giving but begins with vulnerability. The Beatitudes are a promise and an invitation to all of God's children. Yes, to each of you. They are a promise that we will never be abandoned, that we will be given comfort by God's love and grace, ever present in each of us. We will not rest until we change the world and bring about the beloved kingdom of God. The Beatitudes are about you. Every single one of you is one about whom Jesus is talking about. You are the ones who will be happy and who will be bless others by your actions. You will be the ones to comfort those who mourn. We need to keep these words engraved in our hearts. Dr. King's dream. They must become the words of action, not just beautiful words found on a poster in a church or in pages of unused Bibles. We are the body of Christ in the world today, and we must respond to the needs of the community and of the world. Central stands on the corner of Fulton and Pacific in Stockton. While this church is known by its architecture, I hope we are also known by our actions and our gifts beyond our walls. We need not worry about church growth, about returning to the sanctuary after COVID. We must take time to reclaim our gospel mission, our beatitude call. When we grieve the state of our lives and our world, God comforts us through our mission and ministry to change what is to what may be. In the coming weeks and months, as I take a seat near the back of the church, who will step up to be a spiritual guide to our children? Who will take on the mission of encouraging the teachers at Cleveland School? Will you volunteer at Cleveland? Will there be someone who will lead Sunday afternoon book groups? Will you be the one to find new ways to bring comfort to the poor? Will there be someone who will write the articles for Connection and News from 3700? Will our voices be heard in the city streets and country fields to support the poor in our city, state, and our country and the world? Jesus invites us into a life of transformation, a beatitude life. Will we accept the invitation to be his voice, to be his hands, to create a new world for our children? Long ago, a saint by the name of Martin Luther King waited in a jail cell in Alabama for an answer from the church to that very question. What is our answer today? Dr. King's dream has not been yet realized. The world hungers and thirsts for righteousness. We must say yes. We must, because we need to always claim our humble roles as healers of the earth, for our time and place, grateful for the example of our courage we have been given by those who have gone before us, transforming our world as we ourselves are transformed from our mourning into the comfort of others in Christ's name. As we are blessed, become a blessing. Amen.
Friends, we've come to that time in our service when we share a portion of our lives through the gift of our tithes and offerings. Let us worship God.
I pray you'll be your
Loving God, with these offerings, we bring our lives. Help us to move your love into the world this week in the strong name of Jesus. Amen.
Jesus, shine, fill this land with
So, we come to the end of our service. As you can tell, during the service, I took my tie off and my jacket off to be like I am during a children's moment. I should end this time together with you on sitting on the floor with the children, but I'm not. I'm going to say we need to go out in the world and be a blessing to our community. We need to challenge our community as Christians, and we must be the people of Christ in every day. So let us go out into the world and worship and praise God and do it joyfully. Amen. Thank you for joining us this morning. I'm really pleased that you were here. I want to invite you to be with Jan next Sunday here on Facebook and YouTube, whenever you want to watch it, and join us or join us at 9:30 for Sunday in the park. I keep saying we, but today it becomes you and I become a participant in worship. Take care.